That man is in charge of all the illegal oil explorations along the coastal waters of Obolueno Kingdom. All the governments fear him because the man seems to have significant monopoly over instruments of violence. They fear the man. I mean all the governments that come on board, because the man is among the few individuals that rig all the elections in this country. They rig in unpopular candidates so that unpopular candidates can rule popular candidates, because they want men that can cover their illegal business. That man is in so much money. He is a super billionaire. It is even argued in some quarters that he doesn't know how much he has. The king of Berlin has so much money.
Bros, I don't know what my business is in all of this. You and I know that we are not from Obolueno, and it is practically impossible for us to become men of Obolueno overnight. So, why are we discussing their king now?
We are discussing the king of Obolueno because the king of Obolueno is my business. Now, that man is my business. You don't know. I am discussing the man because I am going to liquidate the palace.
Okay, sorry. Have you seen the native doctor that's going to give you the charm with which you will liquidate the palace?
Do you know you're talking about a billionaire king? That's the man you want to go and liquidate, Abby.
Frank, you didn't know where I slept last night.
Where did you sleep last night?
I slept rough because I was thinking how I was going to defeat that man. I have my plans worked out. I want to sleep now. When I lie down to sleep, do not make the mistake of waking me up again, because I want to sleep well. If you wake me up, you will not like what you're going to see. I don't want to get angry. My anger can be tantamount even if you don't believe me. Bro, I beg. I beg you.
My dear brother comes. how long will Dad continue to be in charge of everything? For how long? Come on, Dad is a king. And he should focus on the politics of the kingdom. I am so competent enough to run that oil company in my capacity as Carlson. I don't understand why Dad is just finding it difficult to place me in charge of that business. I don't understand.
You know, I discussed yesterday with Father on this very issue. And listening to you now, I confirm his worries.
What worries?
He was sounding desperate.
I don't get it.
Yes. Father is not an illiterate. He is watching you. And the state of your desperation, he noticed that too. And I'm sure that is the reason why he doesn't want to hand over the business to you fully.
No, let me get this. Is Dad thinking that I might sell off the company or what?
Brother, I'll take you to Father now. When we get there, please, I beg of you, tell him that you respect his opinion. Tell him that you have tremendous respect for his leadership qualities and make him believe that you're willing to toe his line.
My dear sister, I don't think I'm ready to swallow those words you're putting in my mouth. Fine, I respect the fact that Dad has exceptional leadership qualities. I respect that. Crying out loud, we are not talking about the politics of the kingdom here. We're talking about the business empire. Okay? There's a difference between the business and the politics. Alright? Our dad should be made to understand that he's not such a wonderful businessman. I am better than him.
But he is the founder of the business empire.
It does not matter. Okay? Somebody will always find something.
And he single-handedly nurtured it to its greatness.
We are not saying otherwise.
Please, dear brother. You know, your comportment and your reasoning is getting to him. And I believe he knows what he is saying.
And I know what I'm saying too. Look, let me tell you, Dad is an old school. I'm a new school. His time is up. Okay?
Carlson. Decision you take today might ruin you or tomorrow. You're my only brother. I don't want anything bad to happen to you. Please submit to Father's supremacy. I beg of you. Please, he will bless you, not just as the king, but as our father.
There's something of importance you want to discuss with me. But before you say anything, I need to announce to you that I have decided to make Carlson, your brother, a co-signatory to all the accounts of all the businesses. Now, the banks are on their way with necessary documents for us to sign.
Father, you're kidding me, right?
I speak the
Now,
that is not to say that I am retiring from business, but there are other challenges I face as the paramount ruler of this kingdom, and I have decided to make my only son take charge of the businesses.
Father, your decision has overturned what we actually came to discuss. I must say we are very happy.
Well, you speak for yourself, my princess. Your brother is yet to say a word.
Oh, Dad, I mean, she just said everything. I don't know what to say. Dad, your decision is quite excellent. I must say that you have the brains of angels. Dad, look. I promise you,
yes.
On the grave of my late mother, I will not disappoint you.
You do not have to tell me so. I know you have something out there. I already know that.
Thanks, Dad.
Now, you go into the chambers and pull out all the memoranda I sent Mira's businesses.
Alright.
You need to be grounded on the issues of law before you start. Now, it has been rumored in certain quarters that I am involved in illegal businesses. I tell you, that is arrant nonsense. My businesses are legal. That is why I will register with the government and pay taxes to various governments.
Well, brother, don't you think we need to celebrate? I mean, Father just solved our problem without even asking.
You are rushing things. I was just going to get to that. It's called for celebration. All right, it's called for celebration. Just give me a break. We're going to pop champagne.
Well, then pop champagne.
Yeah, so. Me. Just give me a break. I'm telling you. I'll be right back.
Bros, bros, look, there's something I don't understand. You're beginning to treat me like I don't have brains, and I don't like it.
With all due respect, Frank, you are not making sense to me at all.
I don't make sense. Okay, why are you just trying to bring our family name to ridicule? Why? What have we done to you to deserve this disgrace you're trying to rub on our face? Of all the millions of women out there, the only person you sought to marry was a cripple. You want to go get married to a cripple? How are you going to present her to her father? How are you even going to open your mouth and tell him you want to get married to a cripple?
Frank, I am not seeing our father. I'm not even seeing the family. Eh? This is my business, and I am doing this my way. I don't want the family to get involved. I am going to get married to that cripple because I have realized that I can become a millionaire through marriage.
Let me use your exact words. You're not making sense to me.
Okay, is that what you think? I'm going to break it down for you. I am going to marry that cripple because her status as a cripple has reduced her to an indoor woman. She's always inside the house. She doesn't go out. Are you telling me that you don't know all these ladies that are driving brand new cars, air-conditioned cars? Their husband will buy cars for them and they will be in their offices and their wives will be somewhere else. Can they ever wash on anything? Can they ever swear on anything that they know where their wives are? After buying brand new cars for their wives, and their wives are cruising. You see all these wives in the supermarket giving out their numbers, exchanging numbers. Have you not been seeing them in hotels with men that are not their husbands? All these nonsense ladies that are driving cars. I want to marry a cripple because she's always inside the house. When she wants tomato, I will go and buy. When she wants apple, I will go and buy. If she wants vegetable oil, I will go and buy. If she wants even red oil, I will go and buy red oil. I will be the only one that is negotiating this lady. I will be the only one that is downloading the lady. I want to marry her. You understand what I'm saying?
Bro, you... Can you listen to yourself? Can you just pause for a moment and listen to yourself?
You are
because you want her to be indoors. That is why you want to go get married to a cripple. Anyway, you know the kind of village we come from. You know the kind of village you and I come from. They will finish you with their mouth if you get married to a cripple. Go and get married to a cripple.
Have you seen the reason why I don't follow you to the village? When you are saying Christmas, you are preparing for Christmas, I don't prepare with you. I don't go there. Men will be talking what do not concern them. Listen to me. Do you know how much Ezomema gave the man that married Kate, the second daughter?
What is your business with what he did?
We are talking about a man, a lucky man, who married a normal girl, normal beautiful woman. The lady we are talking about, her name is Kate. If she appears even in Abuja, the senators, the men in government, all of them will be very humble. They will be doing everything humanly possible to take a cut. The young man, the lucky man, got married to her. And Ezomema went berserk and gave him a company and 500 million naira to start his life. Mm-hmm. What are we talking about? If I should go and marry that cripple, don't you think Ezomema will actually break his head? The man will go mental. He's going to give me 1 billion naira. And if he has not taken, he can even give me the company.
Okay. Are you sure he's going to bring the money if you marry his daughter?
You know, there are some questions that you don't even have to ask. Because when you ask the questions, you expose your ignorance. Every day, Ezomema is praying for miracle to happen. In the palace, they see Rose as a problem. And when the man kneels down to pray in the church or in his private room, he's asking God to cause a miracle to happen so that somebody will come and marry Rose. They want her to get out of the palace. Even as we speak now, it is possible the man is still praying, hoping for the miracle to happen. He doesn't even know that his prayer has been answered. This man that is sitting before you is the miracle. I am going to marry Rose, and we are going to become millionaires.
Wow! Rose, look here. You know what? You don't have to convince me anymore. I am 100% convinced now. We are going to marry the cripple.
I don't understand what you mean by we. I am the person who is going to marry the cripple, not you.
I know, but you're my brother. Your wife is our wife.
Frank, no make me vest now. This marriage is the side of my brain. It's the product of my endeavor. Now, me, where do they plan this disease? I don't know where you are coming from. What do you mean by the we? I am going to marry the princess, the cripple.
It's okay, good. Okay.
Anyway, let's not argue over nothing. Just go woo the girl. Get her to your side. Then we'll get down and plan.
If I should get angry with you, you go like, why do you talk we? I am going to marry the princess, the cripple. You are following me as my brother, as my partner. If you prove yourself to be a credible partner, I am going to make you the best man. If you prove to be an idiot, I will look outside for the best man. Don't say we.
It's okay. What matters is the money.
How do you use this we?
There's a problem here in this palace. I have come to take that problem away. If you know what I mean.
Are you sure you know where you are? How dare you come here and say there's a problem here?
You know, this is the very first time I'm seeing you and I'm beginning to like you. Look at you. You're looking very official. You suit, you know. And your English is very, very refined. I have this feeling that you are schooled, you know. And you fully schooled. you are seeing me here now, I have passed many examinations. Many examinations I have passed all.
Are you okay?
What is that?
Are you sure you're okay? Please, just get out of this place. Right now. I don't want to get upset with you. Just get out of here.
Wait. They are getting angry. Can't you understand? People do not just rush to say what they want to say. They play. I was playing. I was just cracking joke with you. You are getting angry. Consider everything I said so far as a joke. Don't take them to heart. Now let us get them to specifics. Go inside. Tell Princess Rose that her fiance is waiting here. There is nobody who is not her fiance that will come here and say that he is her fiance. That's not possible. I am her fiance and I have come to see her. You go inside and tell her that her fiance is waiting. But I want to see her. I am her fiance.
Well, you're looking quite well, son, and that tells me my daughter is doing okay.
You're right, Your Majesty. My wife is okay. And she asked me to tell you that she dreamt of you last night.
Awesome. See, I dream of them every night. They are more than just treasure to me. Which is why I go out of my way to make sure they are happy.
Right. Your Majesty, I actually came here to ask you if you would help me sign a reference letter.
A reference? Well, I can always sign something for my son-in-law as long as what I'm signing will not land me in trouble.
With all due respect, Your Majesty, I cannot ask you to sign something that will land you into trouble, Your Majesty, sir.
Very well then. So, what would you have me sign?
A consortium of journalists approached me and asked me to float a newspaper campaign. Initially, I thought it wasn't going to work, but gradually it started taking shape. And the Ministry of Information is about giving me the license. And they asked me to get a reference from a first-class citizen. And that is why I'm here, Your Majesty. You are my father-in-law, and you remain the first-class citizen I know.
Very good. That's wonderful. That is quite wonderful. So, where are the papers?
Here, Your Majesty.
They have made wrong statement is to withdraw their statement. Most of them will end up withdrawing very important statement. I am not always in the habit of withdrawing my statement because ever before I open my mouth to make any statement, I have already concluded what I'm going to say. I don't speak anyhow.
And what is that supposed to mean?
When I told the corporate guy, the one you just confirmed to me is the head of Palace Security, when I told him that I was your fiance, I was only trying to put myself in the position that I want to be. I want to be your fiance. In fact, I want to graduate, I want to be your husband. I'm pleading with you to open up a small space for me, and I'm going to show you that I have the capacity to be the best husband any woman can ever have. I'm very serious.
What makes you think I want to marry you? Why are you coming after me?
Rose, I have this feeling that you do underestimate yourself because of this wheelchair, that you're confined to the wheelchair. I don't see this wheelchair. In fact, I am looking at you beyond this wheelchair.
I'm seeing the noble woman that you are. The real woman that is in you. You are the reason why I go to church every Sunday. And each time I sit in the church, and I see you being waved towards the altar for you to go and give your offering. Something in me tells me that that's your wife there. And I have this thing that is pushing me to rush out. I don't want to be the one that is pushing the wheelchair, but I will always control myself because I know it can be embarrassing in the church. You may even feel embarrassed yourself. That's why I came here. I want to look into your face to tell you that I love you very much.
I'm sorry, boss. But I don't believe.
Why would you say that? But tell me, what do you want me to do to prove to you that I am serious with this proposal? I love you from the deepest part of my heart. I want to prove to you that I am the best husband any woman can ever have. I want to do for you what you can't imagine anyone doing for you. You spoke with this whole space.
I am not a lady of two.
Trust them, then we will have nothing to do with them.
Aren't you being a little too hasty? I mean, you know this business more than I do. I don't like them, but maybe if you see them, you may like them.
It does not work like that, my dear. See, my father trusted me. And as a responsible father, I must also trust you and trust your judgment, especially now that you're representing the organization. Now, if you don't trust them, you should be able to come out boldly and say, no negotiations shall continue.
Well, I think I'm humbled with the trust that. But I still suggest you see them.
Very well. Bernard is visiting. Have you seen him?
Yeah, I saw the car outside. Maybe he's upstairs.
Bernard is establishing a new super company. Oh, the Ministry of Information is on the verge of giving him license. Isn't that a wonderful thing?
Dad, I hope Bernard has not come here for you to give him more money.
Oh, the young man has not asked for money. But why do you take it that way?
Dad, excuse me, I...
Hey, son. Bernard is married to your kid sister, my only son-in-law. Establishing a new super company is capital intensive. So, if he needs more money, we should be able to give him more money.
Dad, I think I should excuse you so that you can concentrate. Let me go and study the memorandum that you asked me to study.
Very well.
Yeah, I think it's better than sitting down here discussing Bernard.
Believe me when I say that I love her. She is the only reason why I go to church on Sundays. Just to go and see her. I'm telling you. You know, I saw how both of you interacted. And I have this feeling that two of you are getting on well. I'm taking my leave, but I just called you out here to beg you for a favor.
when I was going in, I lied when I said that I was her fiance. I'm not her fiance. I'm telling you, just something that you said to get to her presence. But she was looking me into my face and she said that she doesn't believe me. You are the only person that can make this thing work for me.
Well, I don't know why you're telling me this. What do you want to do?
Looking at you from that very first time, I know that you are strong. You have every single trait of academic. I'm seeing you can make this thing work for me. I just want you to, you know, create small opening so I can just achieve my objective.
Well, my princess, I don't know whether you know her too well. She has masters in three disciplines. And she's not the kind of woman that any man can just come in and get so easily. But the only good thing about it is that she's too emotional. Okay? And you can exploit that. That weakness of hers, you can just exploit it and go through her. That's all.
Can you just help me? Guide me, how do I explore this weakness? This emotional. How do I achieve it? Just man no man, just confide in me, man no man. I beg.
Just go.
Huh?
Just go and come back tomorrow. The fact and issue is that I'm happy that you understand that I have a part to play in this. That's all.
You know, I cannot boast of knowing your tradition here in this land. But where I come from, it is a taboo for a man to send another man on an errand without giving that man a token. I just want you to consider this as my token, as I'm sending you now on an errand.
Just have your money back. Just have your money. We are paid well here, okay? Me looking at me, you will know. Let me tell you. I am building a mansion in my father's compound. So I don't need this here talk. I'm just helping you for helping sake, that's all.
2,000?
Look at my shoe. Just look at my shoe. I bought this shoe $25,000. I don't need this. I'm just helping you for helping sake, that's all. Just well, hand it back.
She's not a cripple as in crawling on the floor. No. She moves on a wheelchair. And her wheelchair is one of the most expensive in this part of the world. That's to tell you the kind of money they have.
So, the only reason you have to support your brother to marry a cripple is that she moves around with an expensive wheelchair. What type of a son are you?
Papa, you know the problem we always have with you. It is the fact that you underestimate your sons. This is a business initiative, Papa. I want you to see it as that. Okay? This is an opportunity for us to enter the king of Obuleno and liquidate him.
Mena, so you are supporting your brother to marry a cripple because she is from a rich family?
Father, without fear of contradiction, my answer to that question is yes. There is business everywhere, even in marriage. Okay, listen to this. This king we're talking about has two daughters and a son. Now the lucky chap that married the younger daughter was presented with a company and ₦500,000. I want you to imagine how much he would be willing to shower on any man who presents himself as a suitor to the older daughter who is crippled. Don't you see it's a business? It's a business initiative.
Look. You can never buy me with this year long someone. Go to Paulson and tell him I am not in support.
Hey.
Tell him that, yes. Papa.
Fine. In that case, we have to proceed without you. Yes. We're going ahead with this marriage without your permission. Why do you always come up against any business proposal we bring up? Why? This is the reason we still remain poor. Now, we're going to become in-laws with Ezumema, whether you like it or not. And that's it.
It's never going to work. My son will never marry a cripple. Never.
If you ask me, I would say that I saw seriousness in his face. He said you are the only reason why he goes to church every Sunday. And I think that statement is suggestive.
Suggestive as
in what? I may not be able to define love. I think my man is in love with you. He's in love with you, my princess. The only reason why he came into this place to propose to you, according to him, is because he's been watching you for a while. I think that man means well. I should be given a chance.
I am not impressed with your visage. Is anything the matter?
My dad told me you were planning to open a new silver company. What do you mean by that?
Yes. Your sister started it first. You know, she brought a consortium of major journalists who were able to talk me into opening a newspaper company. And I was happy with the whole plan because it's going to help her practice what she studied back in school, journalism.
So, are you telling me you have the cash to go about it?
I'm sure I have the cash. You see, the issue there is that you don't know how I value your sister. See, I don't joke with anything that will make her happy. And she's the one going to run the printing company. And I'm ready to do everything in my power to make sure I establish it for her.
Okay. That sounds good to hear. So in that case, calls for celebration.
Yeah, it does.
So we'll go to the bar.
Why not?
I must say I'm glad you came for my sister's hand in marriage.
Thank you.
Yeah,
thank you.
Well, I've heard everything you said about watching her over the years at the local church. I'm impressed.
Thank you.
But then, there's a hurdle. My dad may not be impressed because he loves her dearly.
I know how much your father loves Mrs. Rose.
You don't need to tell me because I know. That is the reason why I came through you. So that you can help me make this thing work. I spent my time monitoring your sister. Because I love her. I want you to make this thing work for me. If I marry your sister, I'm going to be the best husband that she will have ever.
I want to ask you a question. And I want you to answer me sincerely.
Okay.
Why do you want to marry my sister?
But I said it already. I want to marry your sister because I love your sister very much. I love her so dearly. I spent time, quality time, monitoring your sister, trying to do everything about her. That's because I love her.
Before you go further, are you sure you can cope with her?
Why not?
Now, what I'm saying is because my sister cannot cook. And I know men can be crazy about food. In fact, she cannot do anything. All she does every day is wake up, pray, she goes to swim, she eats, she reads, she has no sense of fashion, she's got no friends, and...
Can't you just don't be offended? But I know every single thing you're saying about your sister. I told you that I have monitored your sister. I know her well. If you set your sister like a celebration, I'm going to pass with distinction. I know her. I want to marry your sister because I love her. Help me to convince your father because your father seems to be the problem that I have. If I marry your sister, she's going to enjoy me like no woman has ever enjoyed any man on earth. Come to think of it, why would your sister even cook in the first place when I'm there as a husband? I will do everything with cooking. I will serve her breakfast on bed. I'm telling you, make this thing work for me, please.
The problem with you is that you write off yourself completely. Being confined to a wheelchair does not change the fact that you're a strong, noble, and beautiful woman. You have to look beyond this wheelchair. Stop feeling like you're incomplete. You're a complete woman. So don't be surprised that a suitor is coming your way.
Kate, you don't understand. Every woman should be able to cook for her husband and keep her house in order. My condition will not allow me to do any of those.
You can always engage paid employees to do all that for you. I mean, how many women can boast of your education? This man came for you because he knows your value, and I think it's right to accept him.
It's not going to be easy. You know, I've read so many books written by celebrated women of Christendom, and I know I may not be able to cope as a wife. I have my attention focused on so many other things. I don't want to think like a wife. I can't be a wife. I can't.
I'm sorry, Rose, but it is time to stop reading books and face reality. I mean, there are many women scattered all over the world. This man saw all of them but still came for you. He knows you can't walk. And I believe he loves you the way you are. So you have to be positive and think of success.
I don't ever want to be a failure in life. I may go into this marriage now and it will fail.
It won't be a failure. You're going to go into this marriage and it's going to be a success. Okay? Be positive for once and you'll see what God will do for you.
Frank, you have to do me this favor. Go to our father and tell him that his plan is not going to work. I have listened to him in a number of issues. This is the very first time I will not listen to him. Go back and tell him that I said so.
We have already told him we are proceeding without him.
Not just without him. I can proceed without anybody. Why would he even go to our father to take him about this in the first place? Why would he go to our father?
I told him because he's our father. I mean, you don't expect to start and end a marriage procedure without informing our father, do you?
But I already told you, Frank, that this marriage is not going to last. My plan is simply to make money from His Royal Majesty as a member of Ubulueno Kingdom. This thing is business marriage. It has nothing to do with love. I don't need our father for this thing. Why would you go and bring our father into it? Why?
Bro, if this king asked about our father, what are you going to tell him?
Yeah, when you talk like this, I have this feeling that you don't even know me. You think I am an idiot that has no plan? I know what I have already resolved this thing long time before you came with your question. I am going to tell His Royal Majesty as a member that I am an orphan. Very simple.
No, bro, that is rude. Because our father is still alive.
He's alive, yes. He's alive. Physically, yes. But financially, the man is dead. I don't need men who are alive physically. I need men who are alive financially. There are men that died many years ago physically. Many years ago, even before we were born, they died physically. But financially, they are still alive. Their children are still swimming in money they left, in companies, in investments. Why would I ever go to Ezio Memma and tell him that I have a father? What has my father done for me? What has he done for you? Nothing. When we tell this man that we are orphans, the man can be moved to tears. The man, out of pity, can even give us like 2 billion naira for us to start our lives. Why would you mention father and limit the gain?
Do you know this man might decide to investigate our background? What if they decide to investigate our background? You don't expect a man of his status to just give you his daughter without trying to find out where you're coming from or who you are.
Even before you ask the question, I've already resolved what I'm going to do. There are many people that we're going to hire, people that we're going to present as our relatives, like Mami Sioma, that you know, old woman. She can do anything for money. She is old, but she's still a business woman. What about Mr. Sadebe, that you know? All these men, we can gather all of them together, you know, make them part of this charade. They will follow us. We'll present all of them as our relatives to the king. Before you know it, everything is working. The girl is here. In whichever the girl, and all the money involved.
Bro, I can see you have it all planned out. But I still have this feeling that, knowing the kind of father you and I have, that man is capable of turning up on the day of the wedding ceremony to disrupt it.
You know this thing you said, I never thought about it. But now you say that, I'm beginning to have a feeling that you're making sense. But I wanted to go to him and warn him immediately not to try it. Because if that man tries it, if our father should come on that day to destroy anything, oh my goodness, I'm going to kill him, I swear to God. After killing him the first death, I will personally handle his second death to ensure that he didn't appear anywhere.
Bro, you're talking about our father here.
Why would he appear to destroy my business? Tell him that this is business marriage, nothing to do with family. Nothing to do with anybody. I am pursuing my future. I am pursuing billions. I don't want any interference. Please, I don't want our father to be involved in this. Go and tell him that's what I said. Please. I beg, please.
Son, are you aware that the doctor who carelessly crippled my daughter is still in prison? I've not forgiven him, and I would never forgive him. So Rose's happiness is of paramount importance to me.
Dad, I know all of that. See, that's why I am advocating that we consolidate her happiness by allowing her to marry that guy. Okay? There are so many single women out there pretending to be happy, but we know they are not. Okay? An unmarried woman is not a fulfilled woman. She's frustrated. And we wouldn't want Rose to be frustrated, would we?
Son, I respect your judgment, son. But I don't like the fact that you consider my princess frustrated. She is not frustrated. I will never be frustrated. I have money. And I made enough money. And even if I stop making money today, I have enough for her to be fulfilled for the rest of her life. She is a grade one princess in this kingdom. And the fact that she is confined to that wheelchair does not mean that her fulfillment will take her away.
Dad, look, it's not all about the money. I know you have all the money, but look, she needs to have a life. Okay? I've discussed extensively with this young man, and I can tell he's enough. Don't punish your princess, Dad. Allow her by this way.
Well, I don't see any reason for any prolonged discussion on this matter. When I see the young man, I will see my mind.
You don't need to beg me to accompany you to your in-law's place. I'm always available for you. If you tell me the exact time we are going, I will be prepared.
Is this not the reason why I came to you? Because I know you have a whole lot of things you can do.
Mm-hmm.
In your capacity as Mami Sio, I know what you can do, and that's why I'm here. But you see, the marriage I am planning here is not ordinary marriage.
Hey!
That's why I came to you.
Hey.
Because I need people that have human sympathy, Ndungwelepele Mada, to be part of the marriage. That's why I came to you.
I don't understand, my son.
The lady that I want to marry, she moves about on wheelchair.
She moves
wheelchair.
What do you mean by moves around wheelchair? Wheelchair?
Mommy, so my lady is crippled.
Hey!
But I love her very much with all my heart. My father doesn't believe in this marriage. In fact, my father is kicking against the marriage. Because he doesn't understand the meaning of love. I have made up my mind that I'm going to proceed without my father. Even as I sit here now, I'm still surprised how he was able to get my mother to marry him, whereas he doesn't know the meaning of love. Listen to me, Monsieur. I want people who have human sympathy, people that reason like you, to follow me as I go to marry this cripple. I don't know why people will always abandon the cripple because they are crippled. People will begin to blame them because they are crippled, as if they are the people that made themselves crippled.
Mm-hmm.
It is the same God that created us that created the cripple. So I'm going to marry this cripple. We are not going to abandon her because she's crippled.
Hey, I never knew that you are a good man like this.
I'm surprised you don't know.
Don't marry your father. I will support you. Anything you want, you must marry the girl. You must marry her.
Thank you very much.
Don't worry. I will invite all my friends.
Yes.
We come.
Yes, tell them that we don't have to support.
Yes.
The cripple.
I will support you, my
dear. There's no reason. I don't know why we are living in this kind of world.
I will support you.
Because somebody is crippled. People will just abandon her. They are just talking nonsense.
Someone says they love you. Someone says they need you. And you don't know who. You don't know if it's true.
The young man has arrived with his brother.
Sorry, Kate. I don't want to change.
The young man is very serious. You can't disappoint us all now.
I don't know. But each time I look into his eyes, I feel like I'm addicted to him. And I don't like that feeling at all.
That's the feeling you have when you are in love. It's love. I want you to believe that you're in love with this guy. So the best thing to do is to accept to be his bride. You're going to be very happy, trust me. I'm serious. This man talks so maturely. I mean, you can feel his heart when he talks. So you have to accept him.
Kate.
Yes. You will.
Kate.
I once had a Russian friend. Now this is my Russian millionaire friend. They had a daughter, a very beautiful but blind daughter. He loved her so much and trusted her so much that he made her a co-signatory to all the accounts of the fortune in his kingdom. Then a young man came from Estonia and started to profess love to this young, blind daughter of a millionaire. He engaged in all sorts of gimmicks that even melted the hardest heart. And was accepted. He became part of the family. But this young man wound up being a fraudster. Yes. He liquidated the fortune of this family and broke the young blind girl's heart. Now, the young blind lady took her own life.
Just like that.
And do I need to tell you that my friend died of a broken heart following the death of his so much loved daughter?
Your Majesty, I wasn't there to witness how this fraudster from Estonia died. But that man was supposed to die slowly. What he did is evil.
Yes.
What he did against your friend and the daughter is evil. And such men that engage themselves in evil should not be tolerated at all, Your Majesty.
At all?
Yes.
I see.
Yes.
I see. Are you okay? Tell me. There's one reason for me to believe that you are different from this young man from Estonia.
Your Majesty, the fear of God is the beginning of wisdom.
Yes.
This is the very first thing we learned from our parents, Your Majesty.
Yes.
And this is the reason why every other Sunday I go to church. Even when it is raining, cat and dog, I must find my way to the church.
Point of duty.
And I have been observing Princess Rose in the church. And I've come to realize that she's different.
Yes.
She's very unique.
Yes.
Even when she has been confined to the wheelchair, she has all the potentials of a great woman. I have come to the conclusion that she represents something that is bigger than all the women on earth.
Perfectly.
Even my late mother. Inclusive.
Eh?
Yes. Inclusive, Your Majesty. And that is the reason why I have made up my mind to marry her. I want to make her my wife.
Ah, Marcus.
Welcome.
Yeah, Princess.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Yes.
We greet you well.
What is your educational background?
Your Majesty, I hope this is not going to affect my chances of marrying the woman of my dream, Your Majesty.
Why, you just answer the question, young man.
Your Majesty, I am aware that the princess has three different master degrees in three different areas.
Yes.
I am aware, you know. Yeah, but I submit before you, Your Majesty, that I don't have masters.
Sincerely.
In any discipline. Yes, I don't have masters at all. I said sincerely. But Your Majesty, I have bachelor degree in journalism. Yes, in journalism, Your Majesty.
That's awesome. That means you have automatic employment in my newly established newspaper company.
Sweetheart, I'm not impressed with the offer you just made our in-law here. Our father is in a better position to make him an offer, not cousin or any of you.
And what kind of offer are you talking about?
you just imagine? Did you just imagine this? Can you imagine a fool who abandoned the elder sister, married the younger one, telling me that he's going to give me a job? Now I know that I am mature because I still don't understand how I didn't slap that idiot.
No, it's a good thing you didn't slap him. Because if you had slapped him, it would have put a permanent end to our business. Now, brother, it's evident to us that that fool has got loads of nonsense. But I'll plead with you, let's just continue swallowing his nonsense until we achieve our goal. Okay?
I wouldn't want those demons to spend time talking about him because he's a nobody. My only happiness is that now it is clear to me that the family knows that they are going to make me an offer. You hear when the younger sister says something like that, it actually means they've taken a decision in their family that whoever marries the cripple should be made an offer. This offer is not going to be small. By the time I marry this cripple and they release this money to me, I am going to deal with that animal. I will deal with him so much that he's going to be very confused. I'm telling you, let's just go.
Wait, brothers. There's something you need to clarify me on.
Something like what?
You know, you told them in there that you had a degree. So I was wondering if you bought one overnight.
What are you planning? Are you planning to go back there to tell them that I didn't go to school?
No. Why would I do anything like that? No, I just was caught unawares. You should have told me about it.
Frank, I didn't catch you unawares because you're already unaware. What are you aware of? This is my business. Are you aware? It's my business. I am the one that is negotiating this business. I started it. I am the one that is going to sustain what I'm doing. You don't need to know anything. The only thing that follow me at my pace, whatever thing I say, just say okay. Even if you don't understand what I'm doing. But anything I do, just agree. That is the only way we can sustain in this business. Don't begin to poke into what I'm doing. This thing warrants a lot of lies. I'm the one that is going to be telling all the lies. Just follow me. That is the only way. Let's go, please. Why would you even say that?
Let's go.
No, why would you even say
it
like that?
Dad, why are you being so difficult? Why are you vehemently kicking against this guy?
Son, I am not being difficult. Did you see him when Bernard offered him a job in his company?
In the first place, why would Bernard offer to give him a job under him? Come on, that's an indirect insult to Rose.
See, I don't want to get into personal problems you have with Bernard. What I'm telling you is, I do not trust that young man I saw.
But why, Dad?
But I won't repeat myself on this issue, son. See, the future of all my children is something that is very, very important to me. Because I feel responsible for all of you.
Dad, if you ask me, I would say let's follow the right procedure. Let's remove our personal decisions, personal opinions. Let's take it away. Okay? Because I know Rose is in the picture here. Let us call Rose into this picture. Rose has interacted with this man and she knows him too well. Let's call her and ask her what she thinks about
him. No, I'm not going to call my princess and ask her such nonsense. No, see, I trust your judgment, but I must let you know that that young man like him has nothing that qualifies him to husband any woman, let alone my own princess.
That is where you come in, Dad. That's where you come in. Fix him up. Fix him up. I guess that's the only way forward. When Bernard came here, he had nothing. But you settled him. And now he's dining with the movers and the shakers of the country. Come on, you can as well do, extend the same benevolence to Paul.
I demand an apology.
Apology over what?
You spoke to me in that meeting as if I am not your husband. See, I gave him the offer because I liked him. I liked him as a person. You shouldn't have countered me in front of everybody the way you did. You shouldn't have.
I'm very, very sorry. Okay? I'm sorry. I'm sorry what I said out there got you so upset. But it's just that I couldn't imagine my sister's husband working for me. Please.
I'll let you try.
Seems to like this young man, but he's not my concern. You are my concern here. This young man you are seeing, do you love him enough to want to be his wife?
Daddy, the only thing I see in him is that he is focused, he is determined, and each time I look at him, I feel like I'm indebted to him.
What do you mean by that? Indebted to him? But if you owe him anything, I'll pay him off. Because I'll be devastated if you end up with a man who makes you unhappy.
I don't think he's that kind of person. Because he's from a humble background. I think I like him. Yes.
Like him. Well, I take that statement to mean that you want to spend the rest of your life with him. Very well. Very well.